I'm going to use oxtail. It has so much flavour and it's a cheaper cut of meat. So I've got two pieces there, about 400 grams, and then just some stewing beef. You might think it's beef stew, I'm going to use red wine. Well, actually, I'm going to use white wine. This stew is based on a recipe from Alsace. And in Alsace, they produce a lot of white wine. So in France, the way stews work is they use the wine of the region.
750 millilitres of dry white wine will give a much lighter flavour than red wine.
And then cover it up. You can use some cling film. I'm just going to put a plate on top. And it's best to let it sit in the fridge for at least, you know, 12 hours, 24 hours, or even 48 hours. It takes a little bit of time for the magic to happen. This meat has been marinating for 24 hours. You can see it's absorbed all that lovely wine. I'm going to add some tomatoes. I'm going to blanch them and peel them.
Simply pop them into boiling water for a few seconds.
You can see how easy the tomato peels now. It's like peeling a banana. Super simple.
Slice two large onions.
I was a very keen baker as a kid. My earliest memory was when I was sitting in the sandpit and I'd made a bakery. So I made sand cakes, I decorated them with daisies, and I was charging people a couple of pence to eat sand cakes. Didn't make much money, but that was the start of my career in food, running a bakery from a sandpit. Yeah. I've got some amazing smoky bacon. Something I like to use for cooking is the thicker slices because they keep their shape. Worst case scenario, use streaky bacon. You'll get the same flavour, but you won't get those lovely bite-sized bits in the stew, and that adds another dimension to it.
Sear the marinated oxtail and stewing steak in hot oil to seal in flavour and crisp the outside.
Just put in enough meat so you have a few gaps left on the base, so you don't want to overcrowd the pan, otherwise the meat ends up stewing in the liquid, which is not what we want at this point. We want to get a lovely brown colouring on the meat. All that brown colouring is adding flavour to your stew. I think everyone's grown up with a version of stew. So it's a dish if you serve up for a dinner party. Everybody is relaxed, it's simple, it's something that brings back some lovely childhood memories. When it comes to stews, it's worth investing into a heavy-duty cast iron pan. I mean, these are the kind of pans which are a little bit expensive, but will actually keep for a lifetime if you look after them. My mum has an orange cast iron pan at home, which I remember as a kid, and she still has it. So it's well worth investing in, because this cast iron pan, you can use it on the hob, and then you can pop it in the oven as well. Oxtail takes a little bit longer, but you can see this piece, we've got that beautiful kind of caramelization, that browning which has happened. Now, this oil in here has so much flavour in it. It's got all the fat which we've kind of rendered from the oxtail. Stews is all about just building on the different flavours.
While the bacon lardons crisp, chop three carrots.
It wouldn't be a stew without some soft, tender carrots in it. Don't make them too thin, so you want them quite chunky, because the stew's gonna cook for a long time and the carrot needs to hold its shape. Right, I think the bacon is crispy and golden now. Look at that.
Next, caramelize the onions.
Now, this stew is gonna have a little sophisticated topping. Sophisticated. It's just a layer of potatoes and butternut squash. use a mandolin, or you could use a sharp knife. See, you end up with, they're like 3 millimeters thickness, like potato, really thick potato chip. And I've got butternut squash here. Look at that. You end up with this bright orange color, and that will look beautiful with the potatoes. At this point, you just need to put all your ingredients back into the pan. Lardons go, the oxtail, the stewing beef.
Add the carrots, a pinch of black pepper, and the liquid from the marinade.
And then we've got 1/2 litre of water. Pop your tomatoes in there. I like to alternate it, so I'm doing potato, squash, potato, squash. This is a simple technique. You know, you spend a little bit more time now, and then you get that wow factor at the table when you come to serve it. All right, all the slices have been used up now. Okay, sprinkle salt on the top. Fleur de sel. That goes into a preheated oven at 160 degrees for about 3 to 4 hours. Literally, what you'll notice is the liquid will reduce, so everything will lower slightly, and the potatoes and the butternut squash will look tender. And to finish it off, I like to just take the lid off the last 5-10 minutes and kind of brown the top. So in the oven that goes. Look at this beauty. Right, I'm gonna get a nice portion here. Oh, it smells so amazing. Nothing more comforting than a bowl of stew. Let's have a little taste. The meat is literally falling apart. Homemade stew always brings back those childhood memories of comfort food. It's like a warm hug in a bowl.